extraneous noise, so I have heard all that. I'm quite content that Councillor Tony Cox should continue, because he was in the new constitution from the start, helped members draw it up with me on the Working Party, and he's always shown the principles of accountability and openness and transparency in the way he's conducted meetings, so I'm content with that. Well, the contrast with the state of his party at the moment will have to put that aside in the interests of Wirral's government.
Thank you, members, and thank you for putting your role and trusting me again for another year, another municipal year as the chair of this committee. I'll get the formalities out of the way first. So we have one more vote, which is for vice chair. So do we have a proposer and a name for vice chair? Councillor Laing, Tom.
Yeah, I nominate Councillor Gilchrist.
Seconded.
I wasn't expecting that, Chair. I'm quite happy to accept it and do what I can to serve further the interest of all members with a workable constitution that they respect and meets our needs.
And thank you for that. I think that's a very good suggestion. Looking around the room and the members who we've got on and got on this committee this year with continuity wise. So going to a vote just to confirm, we only have one name put forward, and that is Councillor Gilchrist. So all in favour of that motion? Thank you very much, members. Councillor Gilchrist, thank you for joining me as vice chair. Computer just went up a bit. Yeah, so welcome, members. Welcome to the independent members as well, Mr. Jones, Professor Jones, as ever. Looking around, I think one of the things I finished saying at the end of last year was it would have been good to have some continuity on this particular committee. We've got myself and fellow Councillor Gilchrist, who've been here before. Professor Jones has been here some time as an independent member, and I'm sure he will be able to point us in the right direction. You members, if you've not been on this committee before, it is relatively apolitical. I hope it stays that way. We try to keep it as informal as possible. I don't see any reasons why we need to be heavy-handed at any points in throughout the year. We normally find consensus on this committee. Leaving members from the end of last year actually said that they really enjoyed the fact that everyone had been able to push in the same direction. We do have numerous working groups whereby you can probably speak a bit more freely without the camera pointing at you and tell me what you really think of me. So yeah, we won't have them just for the hell of it. There will be a point to each one. We won't have meetings just because if there's something that we can do in a round robin email that we can agree. We won't just meet just for the sake of having a meeting. But yeah, please feel free to come to me with any concern if you've got any questions about the constitution or you want to bring something to our attention that you'd like debated. Door is always open, as Lee said. Okay, so apologies for absence, everyone is here, so that's item two. Item three, declarations of interest. Members are asked to consider whether they have any disclosable pecuniary interests in any items on the agenda. Are there any declarations to be made? That's a no. Okay, thank you. Minutes of last meeting, that's item four. We need to approve the accuracy of the meetings held on the 13th of April 2023. I think there was only Phil and I who were actually present at that. I couldn't see any inaccuracies. Phil, you are normally ever a better eagle eye than me. Anything in particular?
sent into the government's working group so that we don't just work in isolation.
Thank you, Phil. Anyone else? Slightly different on this committee because we've taken this out of proportional figures because when we, I'll give you the background, when we went to the committee system in order to ensure that every group, because we had the independence at the time, which you'll know about, we wanted to make sure that every group had a voice on that, so we took it out of proportional requirements, if you like, for the council members. So. That's why we're still selecting the chair in here. It's not done a full council, and that's why it's slightly different figures than numbers on the actual committee. So we don't necessarily need it to be proportional. So we were doing initially it was chairs, sorry, spokes, but as I say, last year because we dropped from 11 to 7 people, we thought it was feasible for the working group to still be 7 people. But you need a quorum. You need quorum to. Ultimately, it's the working group's advisory anyway. We can see we're pushing in the right direction on the items that we actually discussed, but you'll still need to come here for a vote anyway to clarify whatever that would be.
I'll put my name forward, Tom. I'll put my name forward as spokesperson.
Yeah, okay.
I'll work with Chris. And who else did you say?
On the member support group are you referring to now?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Well, what we'll do, if we can, we'll give Jill the authority to contact all leaders and for yourselves as well, for your own group, to get names for that. As I say, without ours, it may not be Gary and I, and then with regards to the way we will just open that up to everyone if everyone's happy with that as a move. Jill, yeah. Yes. So on 3.3 page 5 you refer to Judith, yeah?
Sorry, 3.5.
3.5.
The options for the appointment of how it should be made up.
Yeah, I mean, the 7 members last year was what we did last year. So, I mean, if we want to go to, unless you want to move one of the other options, that effectively just move that, we would go back to C.
Informally to just chat through some of the issues before you met formally, so it isn't any less or more representative.
seven members would constitute us, yeah. And so, yeah, but I'm just going to try someone else to speak. That's okay. Can I have a show of hands on that as we move forward? Because we'll let you discuss with the.
I'm sorry, is this on?
Yes.
I've lost the drift there.
Okay. Yeah, no problem. Councillor Green just wanted the clarification as to who the faculty and the seven people will be. So it'll be us. It'll be the.
It's not a big deal, it's on.
No, it's not. It's a good way of doing it, to be honest, to have as many ideas at that. But when we can speak freely, it works well. It works well. So can I have that by sent then? We will give Jill authority to go away to lead us to talk about the member steering group, and all seven of us will be appointed to the working group.
Agreed.
Thank you. And it's in member support steering group annual reports, Jason. Steve.
Yes, thank you, Chair. Good evening, members. This is the annual report of the member support steering group presented this evening for your comment. It's the second time such a report has been presented to the committee. Essentially, it does summarise the work of the group during the last municipal year. Happy to take questions and comments, but I would just like to draw members' attention to three elements of the report that I think are worthy of note. The first being under section 3.7 from the members' portal. So for a number of years, I'm sure Councillors Cox and Gilchrist will recall it's been discussed about having some form of escalation process for members within the portal. That was launched on the 15th of May, and as you can imagine, it's been closely monitored and scrutinised by officers. So an update will be provided to the first meeting
example, if you don't have the app and you want to use a text message, you've got to make sure that you've actually got a signal at that point in time, so you're sort of hanging out of the window with your phone and that as well, so we can, I'm sure we can feed that back to Steve. You want to come up?
Yeah, the frustration experienced by members is shared by officers at times, and all feedback is welcome. I didn't want to go too much into the other things we've changed in the previous year, but we have redesigned the member support offer as well. So I shine a light on the fact that there's a member support pool. So whilst we haven't invested hugely in terms of a budgetary investment, we have rejigged and moved officers around so that there is that network there for you. So any feedback you require, the member support pool is there, so please do utilise and call on. Thanks, Jeff.
I've shared the support steering group during the past year, and we tried to anticipate what would happen this year. We can see that there will be a new group of new members, and try to take views of what would their feelings be on their arrival. I did talk to the members, and some members remember that as I showed the arrival of the prisoner in Fort Marion. That's one of my jokes. But I did send a message that we chose to be here and the electorate put us here. But just like anyone starting out in a new career or in a new job or any other activity, there's a period where you get used to things or find out about things you never thought were cropping up. And we tried in the booklet and the training to provide that. We recognise that for new members, coming in and suddenly facing 3 weeks of intense stuff was quite burdensome. And so it did get spread out a little more, rather than be in your face the first fortnight, wearing people out. It was flexibility, which I think we built in, which I think has worked. But I think the members on the steering group of the government's working party were pleased to hear the results of the survey to see how it actually went down. I often recall my first outings as a councillor in 1977, this is where you go, this is where you pick up letters from the office, and that's pretty well about it. It was something of a culture shock in 77, 78. I have to say, now we're far more advanced as an organisation in helping people. I recount that there was a senior officer who retired in the period just before the elections, who said that he felt with all the training that he'd had in Wirral, starting fairly low down in environmental health and working his way up into various other jobs, he felt that the council treated him and he regarded the council as a family and as a good employer and somebody who was really, we're all here in the best interests of the borough. And it's that spirit that lies behind our training so we can do our jobs effectively, come hell or high water, budgetary constraints, budget problems, and everything else that goes through with us.
Yeah.
comparison to what the original estimates were from outside outside bodies that were suggesting, a lot of the money we managed to achieve, or certainly we managed to achieve with negligible cost, and also we did, the governance group did some really good work in getting a lot of stuff through the LTA and other bodies as well. So they've done everything training wise. That's